So the greenhouse looks like a bit of a building site at the moment. What I'm doing, I'll show you when I get inside in a minute. This is all. It's a mess that I'm going to clean up and put it all back organised. But I was giving it a good clean out, you know, clean the glass inside and out. Hoovering all around the edges because the seal, as you can see, I've started digging a hole. These are all the plants. It's mad out, like, seems a lot of you, but you know, it's all concentrated inside, isn't it? But I've had to redo the flags a little bit, purely because, yeah, there's a pain in the back. But I've started digging this hole, and the reason why, because see that, if it starts getting too big, I can just start digging that down, and then I can have the pot flush to the floor, so it looks like it's, you know, it's flat in the ground. It's quite a deep pot, isn't it, you see, so I'll just put that belly in the ground and then I can get extra height then. So yeah, I'm just giving it a good clean out because all the seal, you know, obviously this was not, I never built this greenhouse, but all the seal's gone round, so I'm just giving it a good hoover out, good cleanse, you know, it gets rid of all the spider mites as well, just especially while it's going into the flowering stage, the most important part where this is where all the mites and, you know, the aphids and all the insects are flourishing basically. So what I'll do before I just throw things back in is I'll obviously inspect every single little plant to make sure there's no aphids and stuff throwing them back in. And especially that as well. Because you just eat one little aphid in there and leave it in the greenhouse, you know, a couple of days, don't forget. Their lifespan's only like a couple of days, isn't it, you see? You know, they breed and have loads of bait, especially spider mites. Spider mites can, like, you know, triple in like a day. So yeah, I'll come back obviously once it's all clean. There's that little hemp. But I'll bin it if it's even, you know, because if it, even if it was a male, I don't even want a flower. I wouldn't even want to use the pollen like off a hemp. On, you know, some THC stuff, it's just not really going to be the best crossbreed, is it? And end up producing like a CBD strain, so you know, half CBD, half THC. So yeah, is I'm just giving a good clean, and I think that's what people should do, really, especially while it's going into the flowering stage, because this is where they've got to take the temperature and everything into consideration, especially the humidity and the heat. And that's it really. So I've got other videos coming, well better ones. I've just given you a little update on the greenhouse itself.